I'm sure you've seen the option for Mip Mapping in San Andreas before. It's in the advanced display settings and it can only be changed from the main menu before you start a new game or load a save. But what is Mip Mapping? To show you what Mip Mapping is, let's first look at a problem with textures in San Andreas or games in general, before going into how Mip Mapping actually solves this problem. You've probably seen high resolution texture mods for San Andreas, such as San Andreas Retextured or ROSA Project Evolved. Both mods which replace a massive amount of San Andreas map textures. Both of these mods have mipmaps, and they benefit greatly because of it. But what if we remove the mipmaps from these mods? Let's take a look with ROSA Project Evolved. As you can see here, everything looks fine with mipmaps enabled. But once we remove the mipmaps, all of the textures become extremely aliased and noisy. As the camera moves, textures shimmer and honestly kind of hurt the eyes. As you can see here, the grass looks like it's moving as CJ moves. The issue becomes even worse when looking at textures from an angle, especially things like fences. So, what exactly causes this issue? To see, let's go back to normal San Andreas textures and go to the train track in East Los Santos. Now, let's replace the train track texture at 1 from ROSA without any mipmaps. This texture has a resolution of 1024 by 1024. Keep in mind, that's 1,048,576 pixels. As you can see, up close, it doesn't look too bad. Not much shimmering and tons of detail. But as we get further away, the texture starts to shimmer again and aliasing returns. So why does this happen? Well, remember I said the texture contains 1,048,576 pixels? Well, basically, all of those pixels are being squashed into a much smaller space as the camera gets further away from the texture. Obviously, all of those pixels aren't going to fit into such a small amount of screen space. So when the texture is forced into such a small amount of space, this is called texture crush. And the problem also gets worse at angles like I showed earlier, as the game tries to retain as much detail as possible. Just as a reference, this is the size of a 1024x1024 texture on a 1440p screen, and this is the size it gets squashed down to in a game at a far distance. The best way to think of this is, the pixels are basically fighting one another as the camera moves, and this is what causes the massive amount of aliasing on high resolution textures when they're crushed into a small amount of screen space. But what if we apply Mip Mapping to the train track texture? Let's take a look. As you can see, the issue is gone. So how does Mip Mapping actually fix this? It's simple really. Mip Maps are lower resolution versions of the same texture. So if a developer generates Mip Maps for a texture, those lower resolution Mip Maps will be used instead of the full resolution texture at further distances and specific angles. Generally, the higher resolution a texture is, the more mipmaps will be generated for it. This usually goes to the nearest power of 2, smaller than the original texture resolution. So, if the texture is 1024 by 1024, the next mipmap for it will be 512 by 512, and then 256 by 256, and then 128 by 128. and so on. These will be used accordingly depending on the distance and angle of the camera from the texture. This isn't a 100% accurate visual representation, but just a quick example of how this would work. Up this close, the resolution of the texture would be 1024 by 1024. But if we go high into the sky, the resolution of the texture has possibly dropped to around 128 by 128. That's only 16,384 pixels instead of over 1 million pixels like the original texture. So instead of millions of pixels fighting one another as the camera moves, the game will simply swap the highest resolution texture with a mipmap when it needs to. This doesn't really result in a loss of quality, as you wouldn't be able to see all of the detail of the texture at a distance, or certain angles anyway. All you'd see is aliasing and noise like we've seen before. The mipmapping option in San Andreas should always be left on. There's really no reason for you to not want mipmaps, especially on any sort of modern computer. Weirdly enough, this option seems to be broken for me, and it never disabled mipmapping even when I had it set to off. But that doesn't matter, because realistically you should always leave this option on. And that's basically it. There is more that goes into what makes mipmaps look good, such as anisotropic filtering, but that's not for this video. Anyway, if you enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a like. And don't forget to check out the channel for more San Andreas modding videos.